In this video, we shall learn about chest compressions. Chest compressions are indicated if the newborn after 30 seconds of effective ventilation has heart rate below 60 beats per minute. Let us first see what is the site for chest compression. The site for chest compression is 1 cm below the internipple line. Let us learn what should be the depth of chest compression. We must ensure that the depth for chest compression is at least 1/3 the AP diameter of the chest. Let us learn what is the ratio of chest compression to ventilation. One compression consists of downward compression plus the release. A ratio of 3 chest compressions to 1 ventilation should be provided continuously for at least 60 seconds. It is desirable that a baby who needs chest compression should be intubated to ensure effective ventilation. All babies on chest compression require 100% oxygen delivery. Once the heart rate rises above 60, the oxygen saturation guides the further oxygen delivery. The best response to chest compression is indicated by rise in heart rate. Let us learn about the technique of chest compression. There are two techniques that are used: the two thumb technique and the two finger technique. The two thumb technique is the preferred method for chest compression. Place the thumbs on the sternum with the fingers encircling the chest. Flex the thumb to apply pressure vertically. The thumb technique assures better control of depth and is less tiring. The finger technique involves applying pressure over the same site using the middle and the index finger vertically over the site of compression. One must take care not to leave the fingers in between. You would discontinue chest compression if the heart rate rises above 60, but continue with ventilation. Thank you.